Coming up on the show, we look at the steps you can take in Azure to secure and manage your VMs in production, from how you can enable threat prevention, receive security alerts, and take advantage of the new just-in-time admin capability, to how you can use Azure Backup with multi-factor authentication to protect against ransomware attacks, and how you can leverage the latest in log analytics to discover and mitigate potential issues. Joined today by Praveen from the Azure team. Welcome.
Thanks for having me in the show.
So this is an interesting topic because a lot of people will set up their VMs and assume that security and management is just taken care of, but there's more to it than that.
That's right. When you provision a VM for the first time, we make sure that you have the latest image and recent updates. We also make sure that you have the performance and availability SLAs are met. For example, we don't overutilize a VM host with too many VMs to compromise for your uptime.
And of course, Microsoft takes care of all the physical security and maintenance of the environment that hosts your VMs.
Absolutely. But once you provision your VM, there are a few things that you need to take care of. For example, you need to be able to enable controls that help you to protect your VMs against threats and to set yourself up so that you can actually detect the breaches and mitigate any kind of issues you may face and manage the security overall. Also, if something does happen, like your data gets corrupted, you may want to have a backup plan for it. In addition, overall, you would want to get right level of visibility into the overall state of your VM, spanning across performance, health, and availability.
And these seem like obvious things for those of us in IT, and it applies to just about everything we do when we think about managing resources, services, and data.
Absolutely. As obvious as it might sound, there are always some kind of false assumptions where people think that all of this is taken care automatically for them. But we don't do that automatically. There are some reasons, because typically in any scenario, in any environment, you might have multitude of permutations of your needs. For instance, you might already have some form of existing tools that you may want to use, or you may have a maintenance window that you want to adhere to. So what we do is we provide you the freedom to control and configure the necessary things you need for your environment.
So tell us how easy it is to configure your VMs to be secure and well-managed.
Sure. I'm here in the Azure portal. You could see that we have broadened the set of security and management tools natively available within Azure, starting with dedicated services such as Azure Security Center, Backup, which is part of the recovery services, and Log Analytics. We provide a set of services and tools that help you to manage overall your operations management.
So can you walk us through a particular scenario?
I'm here at the Security Center homepage, where you can see the set of resources I have, the security state of all my resources, including compute, networking, storage, and applications. Information about the VM can be found under compute. What you see here is the overall monitoring recommendations of all my virtual machines, including cloud services if I have any. For instance, I can find missing system updates. I can also get a high-level assessment of vulnerabilities across all my virtual machines. Specifically, if I click on the virtual machines tab here, you can notice that I can get the security state of all my virtual machines individually.
So that's great for visibility for day-to-day operations, but what about detecting specific threats to the environment?
Let me go back to the Azure Security Center homepage. Here, you will notice that we have set of security alerts that detects all the bad things happening in your environment. It provides me the list of security alerts. For instance, here I look at it and I'm concerned about the failed RDP brute force attack. So let me drill down. As soon as I drill down, I can notice that a specific VM has been attacked multiple times. So I'm going to click on the individual VM instance. It looks like in the last 49 minutes, there are few failed attempts. The service also gives me a set of remediation steps to prevent such attack. In addition, it provides me an ability to apply just-in-time VM access to reduce the attack surface. Let me go ahead and configure it. I'm going to find the individual VM under the not configured one, and I'm going to select that and enable just-in-time VM access. You will notice that I can add specific ports to make sure that I reduce the attack surface. In this case, it has already listed specific ports such as port 22, 3389, 5985, and 5986. I'm just going to continue and save it. Now that it is configured, Once admin needs to get access to the specific server, he or she can scroll down to the individual portal and select the particular server and request access. When they request access, you will notice that they can specifically access a port for a period of 1 to 3 hours, and then select the toggle button here and open the ports.
So what we've essentially done there is cut off access to the VM, and you've allowed a specific admin to tend to it for a specific amount of time. And is that a new feature that we've just lit up?
Absolutely. This is a recent feature called just-in-time VM access that we have enabled in Azure Security Center.
Awesome. And is there anything else that we need to do?
First time when you launch Azure Security Center, you will be seeing the welcome page here. As soon as you see the welcome page, you can click on the Launch Security Center. And as soon as you click on this, the data collection for all the virtual machines under this subscription is automatically enabled. And you can also configure your settings as needed under security policies at a granular level for the individual VMs under the subscription.
That's awesome, and a great proactive mitigation. But what happens in the case of a VM getting corrupted?
Oh, for that, you can use Azure Backup. Let me show you. I'm here in the Azure portal. This is a virtual machine. It's called Contoso SQL Server 1. You will notice that within the VM blade settings, there is an option called Backup. As soon as I click on the backup, it enables me to provide an ability to safeguard my data by creating or selecting an existing recovery services vault where the data is protected and managed and monitored. For this demo, I'm going to select an existing recovery services vault called Contoso Retail HQ. In addition, I can also specify a backup policy. In this case, you can create a new backup policy which provides the granular controls of backup frequency, which could be daily or weekly. It can specify the time zones as needed. In addition, you can also specify the retention range across daily, weekly, monthly, or yearly. For the sake of this demo, I'm just going to select the default policy. The default policy here is a daily policy for 4:30 p.m. on a daily basis, and the retention range is a daily backup point that is retained for 30 days. And as soon as I click OK and enable backup, your backup is ready.
Great. So just a few clicks to back up your VMs. But does it help you protect your data against things like ransomware that typically target the backup process running inside a VM, which ultimately prevents you getting access to your own data?
That's a great question. For that, within Azure Backup, we have a capability called multi-factor authentication, which actually ensures that for every critical operation you have in your backup, you have to have a security PIN. Let me show you how. I have currently remotely logged into a server, and I'm going to simulate a ransomware attack. You can see that this server is currently under attack by a ransomware. Immediately, you will also notice that the data, the live data, has been encrypted by the specific ransomware. Typically, ransomware not only encrypt the live data, but also would try to get control of the previously backed up data so that you as a user don't restore back to the previous backed up point. In this case, it will also try to get access to the backup process which is running in the server so that it can delete all the previously backed up data. What I'm going to do here is try to simulate and show you what will happen in that case. Here I have a PowerShell script that is going to simulate what a typical ransomware would try to do. When I'm executing this PowerShell script, I'm going to make sure that I'm also attempting to delete all the backup data I have had. As you can see, it's trying to stop the backup process, but it is not allowed because a security PIN is needed for all the critical operations in Azure Backup.
So how do we set this up?
Let me show you in the Azure portal. I'm here in the Azure portal under Recovery Services Vault, where I have enabled my backup. You can notice that under the Recovery Services Vault, under Settings, there is Properties. Once you click on it, you have the ability to make sure that you have already enabled multi-factor authentication and the security settings by clicking on this Update link under Security Settings. So I'm going to click on it. You will notice that the security features have already been enabled. In this case, every time an admin is going to execute any critical operation, he or she has to generate a PIN that they can do in this link under Security PIN. You will also notice that the security PIN is only valid for 5 minutes, essentially restricting the access to only legitimate users to perform any kind of critical operations.
And outside of that 5 minutes, no PIMs will work at all?
Absolutely.
That's great. So how do we go about understanding the visibility into what's going on, especially if a problem arises?
That's a great question. Typically, the log data is key. And the more the log data you can collate across different systems, the more greater details of visibility you can get. But you know what? It's kind of finding a needle in a haystack.
So what's the best way to navigate all of this log data?
Let me show you how, within Azure portal, you have this notion of log analytics workspace, where it is a centralized log store that collects all the log data and provides visibility for you. I'm here in the Azure portal. I have already created a log analytics workspace called Contoso Retail IT. Under that, I have the workspace data sources, where I have already filtered the virtual machine called Contoso SQL Server. I'm just going to click on this, and within a single click, you can connect this particular virtual machine into the workspace, and then you can start collecting all the data so that you can collect, correlate, and search for issues and fix issues quickly. Moreover, you can also notice that we have enabled several built-in management solutions out of the box so that you can easily get insights into whatever information you need. This is all powered by the analytics and monitoring capabilities we have within Azure.
And those analytics and monitoring capabilities seem really useful in terms of diagnostics.
Oh, for sure. We enhanced the Azure Analytics service, and we launched an advanced analytics portal, including an interactive query. This portal provides a lot of tips and tricks and easy-to-get-started common queries. Let's assume, for example, you have been notified that there has been a slowness identified in some form of services. You, as an admin, you don't know where to get started. Here, I'm going to create a new query. This query actually tries to plot the trends across all my performance counters, across all my virtual machines for the past 60 minutes. You will quickly see that the query has shown me that most of my virtual machines have not deviated from their usual behavior, but there is this virtual machine which seems to be running slow. And the service is indicating to me to click on this particular purple data point to get some smart diagnostics. So I'm going to click on this to understand what is happening in the specific virtual machine called Contoso Linux 1. You can quickly notice that the machine learning algorithms have crunched the data and identified mutually exclusive graphs pointing to me that the particular spike has been caused by this logical disk category and in the Contoso Linux virtual machine. This indicates to me that there seems to be an intensive I/O operation happening in the specific virtual machine.
Nice, and you've quickly narrowed down the cause using analytics and machine learning.
Absolutely, it's not only that. Beyond this, you can also mitigate this issue by recommending to your admin that this particular I/O operation can be remediated in the future by transitioning the spinning disk into an SSD disk.
So I've noticed that you've configured controls within Azure Security Center, backup, and log analytics throughout this scenario. Are we doing anything to streamline this experience a bit further?
Absolutely. That's a good observation. We are actually working to make sure that you have the ability to enable all these configurations and capabilities natively within the virtual machine. Soon, you will be able to see specific settings and services for your virtual machines directly from the VM blade at the point of creation.
Thanks, Praveen, for walking us through the options for securing and managing VMs on Azure. How can people learn more?
Get hands-on and learn how to create secure and well-managed VMs in Azure by following the links below.
And see you next time on Mechanics for the latest in tech updates. Thanks for watching.